you so much, and thank you everyone for being here. I'm excited to share my research with you today regarding types of social influence in the online purchasing environments. So as I'm sure many of you have done travel purchases online, and typically when you're assessing those purchases, you look to online reviews to see what other guests have said. Well, much of the research has taken an applied focus of reviews and looks at the effects of reviews. However, we still do not know much about the underlying psychological impacts of what's going on in the review environment. To study this, we applied a classic social psychology theory known as social influence. Social influence explains that people are influenced by each other's attitudes, beliefs, and decisions. There are two main types of influence: normative influence, which is the influence to go along with the norm by conforming to others' expectations, and informational influence, which is the influence to believe what people tell you as factual evidence about reality. Now, typically, we have these influences face-to-face or with people we know or with groups of people that we're familiar with. However, we were curious to know, do these actually extend into the online purchasing environment where readers typically do not know reviewers? Because there is no valid measures at the time for normative and informational influence in the online purchasing environment, the purpose of this research was to conduct a measurement scale so that this could be used in future research to examine exactly under what conditions these two influences manifest. So by following proper scale development techniques as described in Churchill's 1979 article, we collected all the data to really look at what these two influences are comprised of. From there, we developed our instrument and used two separate data collections and different analysis to come up with our final results. So interestingly, our final results indicate that the reviewers or the readers in their environment are really looking to identify with the reviewers. They're actually looking to seek the approval of these reviewers whom they don't even know. If their choices were visible to the reviewers, they would actually maybe change their choices. They go along with what reviewers are saying because they want to enhance their own self-image. They also said that they succumb to the social pressure of reviewers and they want to go along with that pressure. From an informational standpoint, they stated that they seek out reviews to look at others' opinions. They believe what the reviews, the content is actually accurate and valid. And surprisingly, they believe these reviewers, who they don't even know, are credible sources. So these findings are very interesting because we see not only that they don't know these people, but they actually don't know anything about them. And it really gives us insight into the connections going on within the online review environment. This research has important implications not only for consumer behavior in general, but also looking at human behavior in our increasingly digital society. Thank you.